These are the voyages of Treasured Times, her continuing mission to explore the oceans of South Florida and the Caribbean, to seek out unknown islands and forgotten places, to give an unforgettable adventure to everyone who is welcomed aboard. Welcome aboard Treasured Times. Maintenance log, April 22nd, 2021. This weekend we plan to finish the interior woodwork and install the new riser we picked up a couple of days ago. It's late afternoon now since we just arrived from home base, and we have no time to waste.
We got a little bit of a mess here. All that. What are we doing?
Putting in some boards. We're trying to do that. Well, Mac closed up.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Finishing up the wall.
I guess I need to cut this piece first.
I see it in your eyes. Yeah, I can read the signs. You need to get away. It's time we make a change. Oh, you know you'll always have me. Baby, I will always stay with you. So put your trust in me. We'll work it out, you'll see. If we get in a car and drive someplace far, yeah, we could go for a ride. The two of us, we don't have to stop. Baby, let's go for a ride. You and I, let us run away. We can go where we want. I'll have your bag if you'll have mine.
Finishing up the wood.
Just living off the edge. Only good times ahead. So let me put a smile upon your face. Maybe make your worries go away. So put your trust in me. We'll work it out, we'll see. If we get in a car and drive someplace far, yeah, we could go.
Today, we're putting this in. That's the riser. My coffee's gone.
Metcalf Marine in Fort Lauderdale, custom exhaust fabricators, made that for us. Beautiful piece. It's like art. It costs as much as a freaking Picasso. And that's only for one engine too. But it is what it is, what they say. I'm still trying to figure it out, but there you go.
So let's go back to a couple of nights ago.
Look at this elbow.
That's the old riser.
They made this out of individual pieces of stainless.
Yeah.
Rolled them and then welded them.
Yep.
Jacket was crap. Inside the nozzle.
Yeah. You could see, shine your light down in there. Yeah, you could see all that nasty buildup. And some of these things are clogged too, right?
Well, they were plugged. I mean, the stuff, I poked it out, but like here, somewhere.
Yeah.
Still inside there.
Oh yeah, I see it in there. This thing had been repaired once before.
Definitely.
Yeah, because there were leaks. There were issues all around here. Mm-hmm. Leaks and stuff.
This has been welded, stick welded.
That was, yeah, that doesn't even look that good. Like, it looks like whoever patched it up before didn't do a very good job.
Mm-hmm.
But
it wasn't a major leak, but it was dripping right on the water maker.
I know.
That's kind of a problem.
I know. Can't have it ruining the water maker.
Here's a new one.
And they welded the barb on there.
Made in America, baby.
Yeah. I mean, this looks nice. Like, all the welds are really, really good.
Stainless.
Yeah.
New super jacket.
Yep. The jacket's nice.
Nozzle recess, so you don't get no spraying.
Yeah.
And continuous elbows.
Yep.
Inside, there's no space joints in there.
Yeah.
No space joints.
No space joints. Looks very nice. That's the new one. So we'll probably be putting that in this weekend so we can get her back out.
Get her back up.
Get her back up and going.
Okay, the riser. First of all, we discovered that the outlet size of this riser is 9 inch. I said 9 inch. Not 8 5/8, not 10 inch. We bought 10 inch, $120 a foot. Whoops, cut it, I own it. Anybody need 10 inch, hit me up, I got some. I got two perfectly cut 12 inch long pieces. I cut and marked perfectly, not like the guys who cut at the store and just whack, 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 and it's all messed up, no. I got your two 12 inch long pieces, perfecto. If you need it, 10 inch, two 10 inch pieces, perfecto. Okay, anyway. Not 8 5/8, not 10, but 9. Okay, where do you find 9-inch hose? You don't. Nowhere. Ever. It's like something millimeter, work of the devil. I don't know this stuff. I'm American. We do things the old-fashioned way. Imperial, baby! So, anyway, 9-inch hose. Where do you find 9-inch hose? China. For some reason, the Chinese can do everything. That seems to be the way America used to do stuff. We could do everything, but not anymore. Now we do nothing. We get it all from China, who does everything. So anyway, I'm having custom fabricated some 9-inch hose. Now, let's talk about quantities. In order to get a piece of custom fabricated hose, you need to buy 10 meters minimum.
Meters?
Yes, this is this point in the video where you're gonna explain what meters are.
10 meters is roughly the length of your average school bus.
Yeah. You're gonna break out a ruler. Okay, that's why I'm pausing. But anyway, meters, yes, 10 meters, that's how much you gotta buy. And then the shipping, if you want it quickly, costs you as much as having the hose fabricated, okay? So you can order it slowly, which is what I'm going to do. I had the hose fabricated and I will have it shipped here via like a bamboo rice boat, and it will arrive in probably 3 months, but we will have it. And in the meantime, we have to use the leftover piece of hose that came off, which is an old crappy piece of black hose, but it should be fine for now. And when we get the other hose, we'll show you that. But that's the riser, custom fabricated. I had to sell off one of my children to buy that. We're gonna be putting that in today. Just cleaning up the cabin a little bit after our woodworking disaster yesterday. Well, not disaster, but
it was a lot of work.
A lot of dusty mess.
So glad we got it done.
So I'm showing y'all how that goes in.
Gonna be cleaning up sawdust now. We'll be battling sawdust for the next 3 weeks.
Thank you.
The fitting for the old hose needs to be cleaned, as well as the turbo riser connection. I also need to clean the sealant and rust off the old hose, since we're going to have to reuse it for now. The riser isn't that heavy, it's just awkward in such a small space.
The bolts are on a thing to where you can pretty much move them around. Okay. Yeah, there's no gasket on the other turbo, just the inside ceramic cleat. Million dollar question, how it's going. Too long, lady.
What? They are too long?
Give me an old one.
The new bolts for the riser are just a little too long. We're going to have to buy the correct ones locally.
Going on a field trip.
Going on a field trip. Any luck with that?
Hey, you know, I cleaned it off because a lot of times the bolt tells you. It has like a little symbol on it I've never seen before. The three lines mean just a grade 5. But that little symbol above it, I don't know what that means.
I'm going to Google it and see.
No go here.
No go.
No go. No go. Oh, okay. Can't believe they asked you that. What's a high temperature bolt?
Yeah. They got grade 5.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They know what it was?
They know what grade 5 is, yeah. Real hardware store know what grade 5 is.
Yes. We should've just came here.
Should've just came here. They gave us some other ones, but they were like a different color. Like, I don't know how to describe it. It was like...
Okay, your bolt always counts as 2. Each hash mark counts as 1, so that makes that a grade 5 bolt. Just like that one. That bolt counts as 2. Each hash mark counts as 1. Right. So, and those are zinc plate.
These are going on to a turbo. You think they'll be all right?
Well, if that was on there, yes.
These are old ones I took out of there. I don't know if they were necessarily the right bolt.
Okay, well, grade 5 bolts will bend before they break.
Okay, then that's what we're looking for.
Okay.
Can you cut us some wire, too?
Sure. Just don't have me cut the cheese. I'm
not all right.
Did he just make a joke?
That'll do you?
I think so.
Yeah, I think so. Yep.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, that's a pretty fancy signature you got there. There you go. Yeah.
So, that guy.
Yeah, that guy. he's pretty helpful when I come in here, but he's usually not quite so friendly. But I'll tell you what, I don't know if it was you that made the difference. A refreshing tradition. I don't know if it was having a beautiful captain made the difference with that man, or it was the camera, but he was extremely...
It was the camera.
he was extremely talkative and extremely friendly today. He even made a joke. He even made a joke, and I'll tell you what, that's...
I know, he even made a joke. Oh boy. Okay, are you ready to lift? Good?
While he's finishing up with that...
Ugh, I'm outside. One thing that I'll be working on today is one of our scupper drains is leaking. And I don't know if I'll be able to get it off or not. I don't think it'll be too hard to get off. I just gotta scrape some of this away, get it out of there. Probably just needs resealed, but I'll have to move the couch and get in there on the inside. Probably cut away some of the fiberglass as well. Whoops. It's a disaster out here. I decided on sealing some small cracks to see if that would make a difference. I ran some water over the area, and sure enough,
yep, hand totally dry. Epic feet!
Yep.
That's done. Now it's time to fire up the port engine. Mic's out. Just need to check all connections for leaks. Looks like we're all good.
Noah, it's next weekend?
Beginning of grouper season?
Yes. And hogfish season.
Pew, pew, pew.
Pew, pew, pew. Gotta get this girl ready to go. Go for a ride.